I've been recording this part for a while, so I think I'll move on to my next topic. So I have a bunch of really random things to talk about today, so I'm just gonna get started. First thing, Romeo and Juliet. This year for our fall play, my school's doing Romeo and Juliet. I auditioned and I got the part of Juliet. I'm really excited, but it's a lot of work and kind of scary. I told one person that we were doing something a little differently, and they were immediately upset about it. It's impossible to perform Romeo and Juliet without upsetting someone. That's terrifying, and I'm kind of worried about it. I'm kind of really worried about it. The show goes up on November 18th, which happens to be my 18th birthday. If you live in Maine and near where I live, then feel free to come. I spent this past weekend at my friend's house. It was really fun, and I really liked his friends. But it made me pretty anxious for college. I've started applying to places, but I haven't really gotten through any applications yet. I'm really close to finishing one, but I do have like 6 schools on my list, so I should probably get working on that. So last night was one of our town meetings. One of the things they discussed was whether or not to grant $51,000 to the local ski resort. This is something really close to my heart, as not only have I been skiing there since first grade, I also work there now. That's my ski helmet, although those aren't my skis. Technically they are my skis, but I've never used them. The real issue for this goes deeper. There was an initial vote on whether or not they should get money. The problem is, the select people offered one amount, and the board of treasurers offered another amount, and then there was also on the ballot $0. Because of splitting the vote of the people that wanted to give them money, they automatically made it so 0-1. There was 1,057 people that wanted to give the mountain money. That's 400 more than those that voted not to give the mountain any. Obviously, this business of the select persons and the treasurers putting in a suggested amount is flawed, and it's going to be dealt with this year. I suppose that my saying that I really want the mountain to stay open will seem kind of biased since I work there. But honestly, I don't get paid very much, and I only work 4 to 8 hours a week, so it's not like it's really going to kill me if I don't have a job this winter. But the mountain's really important to me, and I'm on both the Alpine and the Nordic ski team. So one of the things that I've been trying to do my part to help the mountain, is to give it a little more business. Some of you might know what Dan Brown is doing. No, not Dan Brown the author, Dan Brown the YouTube star. Dan Brown first became popular because of his How to Solve a Rubik's Cube video. Recently, Dan's begun a project called Dan 3.0, where he lets his viewers choose how he rules his life. How they do that is they go on a website and suggest a task. If the task gets enough votes, Dan will do it. My suggested task is that he comes to Black Mountain this year and gets a lesson from me. Not only would it be really fun and really fun to watch, maybe some publicity will help save the mountain. Judging by the amount of voters that wanted to give Black Mountain money before, I'm assuming that it'll go through and that they'll get money along last year. But the selectmen have said that if something doesn't change, the mountain will probably not get money next year. So, this might be the last year of Black Mountain. Unless we can do something about it. Unfortunately, why is it frozen? Oh.